John Cena versus Roman Reigns. This is WrestleMania worthy, but Kurt Angle, I like your swag, man. You're ready to do it. I'm ready to do it. They're ready to see it. We're going to do it at No Mercy live on the WWE Network. This is the reason I came to Monday Night Raw, to be in this ring face to face with a man who says he runs the yard with the big dog, with the guy. And if you don't believe that, just ask him. He'll tell you. And why not? Because ever since Roman Reigns has stepped foot in a ring, he hasn't just been the blue chip prospect. Roman Reigns has been the blue chip prospect that has been protected against anyone and everyone that steps in his path. And then there's me. And we've been through a whole heck of a lot together, and you know me, and I know you, and you know I got zero F's to give, and I'm the one dude ain't no protection from. And that is why I want to fight Roman Reigns, because I know that Roman Reigns don't want to fight me.
Man, a few words tonight, signs still to deliver, looks like. And there's the big dog. That's an imposing figure he's cutting right there. John Cena, a free agent, can go where he wants here in WWE. He came to Monday Night Raw last week and he said, I came here for one man, and that man is Roman Reigns.
Let me get this right. It's all good, Memphis. I'm just trying to check my facts here. So I'm scared to fight you? I don't want to fight you. That's what's in your head. You may not understand this because probably no one's ever told you this before, John. But you're not as big of a deal as you think you are. And this is the fact. I don't care what you've done or what you plan to do. I've done something you'll never do. I retired The Undertaker at WrestleMania. So maybe it's not that I don't want to fight you. Maybe I just don't need to.
You're right. No, he's right. He's right. You don't need to fight me. You are the high exalted Roman Reigns. You are the big dog. Everybody back there knows it. Everybody out here still kind of trying to figure it out. You see, Roman, I'm what you would call a polarizing figure. Every week, there are people that cheer because they stand for what I believe in. And then there are people that boo because they don't. And then every single week, you can audibly hear those people so desperately wanting me to change the content of my character. Maybe a little heel turn. But with you, it's different. I don't know if anyone's ever told you this. They go back and forth with you because when they look at you, they see what I see, a cheap-ass, corporately created John Cena bootleg.
Wow.
This chump right here, he ain't the guy. Dude, you're just a guy. A guy trying so desperately to fill shoes that you never will. Listen carefully, young man. I'm not the Undertaker. I'm not a battered veteran at the end of his career with a bad hip. I am the fastest, strongest, and hungriest that I have ever been in my entire life. And the reason you won't sign that is because you know if you do, your Roman Empire.
He did it again. He's the king of this. He can take anything and spin it. That's what he does. But it blows my mind that he stands out here and he runs his mouth and he's talking about y'all boo him because y'all want him to be a bad guy. They boo you because, first of all, you suck.
Hey, according to them, so does he, but that's okay. He won a gold medal.
Just shut up for a while. How about that? And second of all...
Go ahead, find it. Go ahead. I'll wait. It's called a promo, kid.
Shut your mouth,
John. If you want to be the big dog, you're going to have to learn how to do it, so go ahead. See you, fourth wall.
The reason why they boo you is because they see right through you. You're a phony. You're a yes man who can learn how to do anything or be anything. So if you wrap all that up, you're just a fake bitch. Oh, we're talking now, ain't we? Yeah, you're hearing me now, ain't you? Not only that, he's a part-timing fake-ass bitch. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna bust my ass Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, every single week so you can hang out on the Today Show. Then jump on his big old bus, and hell, maybe I'll come to a WWE show if they pay me enough. But what are you really gonna do, John? What are you gonna do, huh? You're gonna jump off that bus with that big ass shuffle. That big shovel. That's what you're gonna do, and you're gonna bury as much young talent as you can. Because that's what you do, right? That's how you stay on top of the mountain. You'll do anything. You're just a backstabbing shark. But the thing is, the reason why you don't like me, what irritates you about me, you can't bury me, John. You can't touch me. Hell, I think this is fitting. I'm the one guy in the WWE that John Cena can't see. So now tell me this, why would I want to lessen myself, my legacy, my bloodline to be the next John Cena? when I can be the one and only Roman Reigns.
You done? You done? You see, because Roman Reigns is a fool. Roman Reigns is a damn fool. There's an old saying, it's better to keep your mouth shut and have people think you're stupid than to open and prove them right. You, of all people, you waltz down here and use the same pathetic excuse that every other single person before you has done. You, with all your gifts and all your opportunities, you have the gall to blame me. That's fine, big dog. Congratulations. It took you 5 years to get a halfway decent promo, but now I'm about to shrink you down to size.
Oh boy.
Okay. So everybody back there thinks I got this mythical golden shovel, that I got these magical powers, that I can control everything and keep everybody's fate. Dude, I can't tell if you're blind or stupid. Look and listen. They hold the keys. They always have. They always will. But you gotta blame me. Fine, I've been hearing that racket for 10 years and I ain't tired yet. I'm strong enough. I've been called a lot worse by a lot tougher. But you actually believe that I'm a shark, that I hold everybody down, that I swim to the top and keep them underwater at any and all costs. I'm a level with you, homie. I haven't main evented WrestleMania in 5 years. I was the opening match at SummerSlam. I was honored and privileged to earn the United States title at this stage in my career and use it as a beacon of opportunity to introduce new superstars to the WWE like Kevin Owens and AJ Styles, just to name a few. You took the US title as a demotion. And you stand there and blame me. Fine, I blame you. I'm still here because you can't do your job. When it comes to this yard, you probably haven't learned it yet. There's only one rule, step up or step aside. And over the years, there's been a few to step up, but nobody to ever keep up. And then I finally hear about this one guy, the Roman Reigns, the one that can keep up. And now I look at you and I listen to you. You should be ashamed I'm a part-timer, because I can do this part-time better than you could ever do it full-time.